very soon the heat will not be resisted. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Boyle, for being so brief. We are now going to take the next function. So somebody who is representing Zambia, you can hopefully come forward so that we make this ceremony move quickly. Uganda, Ghana, Nigeria, Sierra Leone, South Africa, and Kenya. Is there somebody else who have missed out? So these are the ones who are here. So Zambia, I would like to see all we don't have the representations. Zambia, Uganda, Ghana, very good. Nigeria, yes, I saw somebody put their hand up. Sierra Leone, South Africa, and
decided
now come to the point when we want to close the ceremony, and it is my pleasure to introduce you, the representative of the Cabinet Secretary. Today, in your program, the ceremony should be closed by the Cabinet Secretary for Education, Dr. Matiani, who already opened it for us 2 days ago. And he has delegated his responsibility today to none other than Professor Bonaventure Kere. Kere is the chairman of the Kenya National Qualifications Authority, which is resident at the Ministry of Education in Kenya. He is himself a professor of technical education in Kenya, spent a lot of his time at Moi University, and Kenyans will know University of Eldoret, as we have it today, was hired off Moi University, and it carried with it many people who used to be at Moi University, and that is where Professor Kere now is as a professor of technical education. In between, he has done many things in this country and has taught in other universities within Kenya, largely focusing on technical education. He is himself initially trained in TVET and is one of the few people really in this country who took TVET education to the level that he was able to obtain a PhD in this area in 1989 from Indiana University in the US. We are privileged to have you, sir, to represent the Cabinet Secretary today at this meeting. Please welcome.
Thank you very much, Chelsea. Our distinguished industrialist and Chancellor of Duke Technical University of Kenya, and his dear wife, the Secretary General of Kakupa. Kakupa. Commonwealth Association. Technical universities and polytechnics. We are combining instead of Kappa, so we have to bring in TU. Yeah. The chairman of Kappa, the vice chancellors of Technical Universities present, the TVET fraternity in general, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. It is indeed an honor and a privilege for me to stand here to officiate at this closing ceremony on behalf of the Cabinet Secretary. Ladies and gentlemen, I am TVET. My background is TVET. I went to a technical secondary school. I took a diploma in construction engineering. I trained as a technical teacher. I took a degree in trade and industrial education, a master's degree in technical and vocational education, and a PhD in technical and vocational education. I have been an advocate of TVET all over. I have served with UNESCO as a scholar. UNIVOC, you have heard of UNIVOC, one of the founding members in Berlin, and in fact, Project 2000 for science education also. I have worked in the African countries on policy, on curriculum issues as a consultant for UNESCO and the African Development Bank. I have taught at Kenyatta University, where I was the director of the Center for Curriculum Studies in Africa. Moi University, where I became the dean of the School of Education. Even took sabbatical, went to UNESCO again, and went to work in the Middle East. I was posted to Baghdad before the war as an education consultant, particularly in the technical areas. You know, at that time, we had the UN Oil for Food program, where Iraq could only use oil to import food and educational and training materials, and not for warfare. Therefore, my role as one of those inspectors was to ensure that the technical colleges and the universities were not using the resources for warfare. It was quite a challenging task. Ladies and gentlemen, I have had the privilege of sitting in the deliberations since Tuesday. I came here on Monday, and I've had the discussions and the challenges that have been, shared, committees, the scholars, and in my judgment, the purpose for which the theme of this conference was intended has been fulfilled. It focused on the strategies that TVET institutions should use to ensure sustainability of development in Africa. Ladies and gentlemen, let me remind you that TVET is not new in Africa. In prehistoric times, that was the way of life. As Africa got independence in the 60s, 1961, there was a resolution with the OAU to embrace technical and vocational education for growth. 2008, the AU now had a new strategy reinvigorating the development of TVET. And as you know, with the UNESCO, TVET is the master key because it opens up, it's the one that will actually assist us to produce the goods and services that we need for our communities. AU has a vision, and this is AU's vision about Africa, an integrated, peaceful, prosperous Africa, driven by its own people to take its rightful place in the global community and the knowledge economy. That's Africa's vision. And we'll make that vision realize it. If TVET is indeed the master key, then you know where our role lies and what we should do. How should we get there? There have been many questions in the presentations. But sometimes when I hear presentations from TVET fraternity, some are on the verge of desperation, others on, well, let's just let it be that way. My brothers and sisters, everything depends on you. You must stand up and be counted. Africa depends on you. Dr. Chandaria has just told you that you must take it at the personal level and at the institutional level. The only way that we can make TVET effective is by making it qualitative. And it is us to make it attractive and not somebody else. And how do we make it attractive? If some of you remember, the CS, Cabinet Secretary, mentioned about qualifications. National qualifications frameworks. Some of your countries have them, others are just beginning. Even in Asia, some of them are beginning now to address the issues of standards, competencies that are required for someone to qualify to get a certificate. And in this country, after many years of preaching and assisting our colleagues, even our brothers in South Africa, to come up with a national qualifications framework, Kenya has now seen the light of day, and we are at it. We may benchmark with South Africa. I had published earlier on in my writings about the need for this national qualifications framework. We must do it at national level and also do the same at the regional level. Because that's what the European Union has. That's what the Asia-Pacific countries have. Besides the individual national qualifications frameworks, they have the regional qualifications frameworks. In the East African region, in the entire African region, we need to have these qualifications approved nationally so that our youth can move from one state to the other without impediments. Current studies show, indicate that in the 21st century and in the year 2030, because of the growth of knowledge society, technical skills will be required at a higher level. And you know, we have what we call higher order thinking skills, which are hard skills, and you also have soft skills. TVET fraternity, you cannot avoid not being involved. There was a question, I looked over the shoulder to our speaker about TVET institutions scampering for degrees instead of their mandate. And I asked myself, what is their mandate? The mandate, that doesn't say diplomas or certificates or degrees. But if we in Africa, as colonies of some of the powers in the Western world, for example, Britain, if you talk about Ghana, Nigeria, and Kenya, they had polytechnics, national polytechnics. How many of you have heard of a national polytechnic in Britain anymore? They are no longer there. Believe you me, it's for a good reason. In the 80s, I worked with my colleagues from South Africa in the technical and my colleagues are here, they can tell you. All those institutions became one. What did they become? Technical universities. The threshold, believe you me, in the 21st century, the basic requirement will be the first degree. The first degree. And TVET youth should not be disadvantaged. The reason why they are disadvantaged is still the same reason I saw in 1985, when in Kenya, our technical teachers who had diplomas, when it came to promotion, when it came to leadership, they were bypassed. They were bypassed for one single reason, because they were not graduates. Who says that TVET youth cannot become graduates? It's not a degree per se, but it is in what is a degree. The Vice Chancellor, the professor, said the other day about engineering and technology. Technologists, they combine knowledge and skills. and produce goods and services that were needed for us to meet our needs and wants. Therefore, again, ladies and gentlemen, the ball is back in our court. You, as TVET fraternity, what are you doing? Stand up and be counted. When we talk of issues of employment creation, I had an opportunity to address two parliamentary groups in this country, in this region, and asked them a simple question. How many of you, because you are middle-aged, because you have experience, you have worked for many years, you have handled resources, how many of you would like to go into self-employment? Stop what you are doing and go into self-employment. They were quiet. Then I said, well, I'd like to offer a price. 5 million Kenyan shillings. They laughed. They said, no, no, Professor, that's too little. I said, 10 million. They said, no, no, that's too little. Then I said, 50 million. They said, well, even that is not enough. Then I asked them a question I want to ask you today. If with your 20, 30 years of work experience, you don't have the courage to go out there and be self-employed and create employment, how do you expect an 18-year-old after high school to go into self-employment? How do you expect a graduate, 24-year-old with a first degree, to go into employment? There was a presentation on the entrepreneurship. What were we told? Out of 100%, 20 are entrepreneur, isn't it? Out of 20, most likely 5% will become entrepreneurs, but they can be taught. So why would you expect them to go and get employment? So I'm requesting, and I want us to have a deal today as you go away. Promise me that if you have worked for 20 years in your area, that you will resign and go into self-employment and start job creation. Create jobs for youth to move in. And the position that you hold, let the youth come in and also gain that experience. That's where we must go to begin. And if you are an institution, a TVET institution, be an incubator for the innovations that we have from our youth. Let them test them out. Produce for the market and the market sell through IDU, income generation units. It will be income for the institution. And when you have it is steady and you know that it's now a product in the market, let your entrepreneur, the youth, go set up, be your agent out there in the world of work, and set up, establish a production line, help them continue. That's how we create employment. Dr. Chandaria, with his companies, he has done more with this country than anybody else, creating employment. You have the number of people that he has hired. So what are we lamenting here? So TVET fraternity, please, let us get out there. Let us create employment. And through our institutions, let us do the same. Because the private sector is prepared to help us. And through legal frameworks, they can be encouraged. And as we said in some of the meetings, discussions, I say, unlike Americans, we don't like lobbying. In America, professionals lobby. It's their duty to bring the politicians, the policymakers on their side. And what are you doing? We have a habit of sitting there lamenting, oh, they don't like me, oh, they don't allow me to do ABCD. It is your duty stand up and be counted, make your profession and try it. For our youth, I'm speaking with you, the Tibet fraternity. If I ask you, do you have a professional Tibet organization where you can have the, a say in the policy, in the curriculum? Do you have such a thing? The lawyers have theirs. In practice, if someone messes up, they can be deregistered. The doctors have the same. What about you? Think in the same line. So, ladies and gentlemen, with those few remarks, it's now my personal duty to declare this conference officially closed.
Thank you. chairman of the executive board of CAPA. And our distinguished guest speaker, Dr. Man Chandra, so kindly to Dr. Man Chandra, the foremost industrialist, entrepreneur,